Hello friends, in this tutorial we'll study how to design a binary tree from given pre-order and post-order sequence. Consider this pre-order and post-order sequence given to us, then how to design a binary tree we'll see now. As we know, in pre-order sequence, root always comes at the beginning. So I can easily find the root of this tree from this given pre-order sequence. So I can say that A is the root of this binary tree. So we'll draw that root node into the solution. The first node that we design in the binary tree is A. There is a root node. So this is our root node. Okay. So to get the next node below node A, we will take the next element from the pre-order sequence itself. So the next element is B. And then we'll go to post-order sequence and we'll check where node B appears. If it appears before node A, it means it is the part of node A. It has to be placed below node A. Now, before placing node B below node A, we have to decide where to place it, whether to the left hand side or whether it should be placed into right hand side. Now, the rule says that if the node does not have any left or any right child, then the coming element must be placed to the left hand side. So, we will place node B below node A like this here. Okay. Now, after placing B into the tree, we'll go and check the next element from the pre-order sequence, that is node C. We'll pick that element C and again we'll check it into the post-order sequence where it appears. It appears before node A, it means it is the part of node A, but it also appears before node B, it means it is the part of node B. It has to be placed below node B. So where to place it? We will place it to the left hand side of node B, because node B does not have any left or any right child here. So we have successfully placed node C in the diagram. We pick the next element from the pre-order again. So node, that is node E, and we'll check it into the post-order sequence where it appears. It is appearing before node A, also appearing before node B, also appears before node C. It means that it is the part of node C. It has to be placed below node C. Now node C does not have any left and right child, so we'll place it to the left hand side of node C in the diagram. This is node B, node C and node E here. After successfully placing node E in this diagram, we'll pick the next element from the pre-order. After node E, there is node F in pre-order. We'll pick the node F and we'll check it into again post-order sequence where it appears. It appears before A, it also appears before B, it also appears before node C. It means that it is the part of node C. So if you go into the diagram and check where to place it, now C, node C's left part is already occupied. Whenever the left part is occupied, we'll place the coming element to the right side of node C here. So F will be placed to the right of node C. Then after placing node F in the diagram, we'll pick the next element from the pre-order, that is node D, and again we'll go back to check the post-order sequence where it appears. Node D immediately appears before node B. It appears before node A and it immediately appears before node B. It means it is the part of node B. Has to be placed below node B. We'll go and check it into the diagram and we observe that the left part of node B is already occupied. It means the node D must be placed to the right side of node B. So we'll place it here. So we reach to the last node of pre-order sequence. It means we have covered all the nodes of placing all the nodes into the diagram. So I can say that this is our binary tree, final binary tree. To check whether the binary tree designed by you is correct or not, we will traverse this binary tree. We will traverse this binary tree again in pre-order and post-order sequence. And if you get the same sequence like this, pre-order and post-order, after traversing this tree, if you get the same sequence given in the input, then we can say that the tree designed by you is correct. Otherwise, it is wrong. Thank you very much for watching this video.